Good evening. Breaking news. A major southeast shopping centre is now a COVID exposure site with a series of stores visited by a confirmed case. We have everything you need to know tonight.
Contact tracers are right now connecting the dots and chasing down those who may be impacted. Though in the battle against the virus, authorities feel we have the upper hand.
Suddenly, despite the overnight cases, the mood seems more relaxed, almost as if everything's under control.
Even though the numbers might seem a little bit large, it's good news. They're all linked, so that's really, really good news.
There were four community transmissions overnight, including the woman identified late yesterday. The others are a child and the partner and a colleague of the man who went to the Sunshine Coast, including Umundi, while infected. All have the alpha strain.
We do not believe that the Delta variant is circulating in our community, which is excellent news. Just goes to show that those short, sharp lockdowns do work.
They also believe they found the connection to three recent unlinked cases, including the second Prince Charles hospital worker, the Zoo Street Greek Kitchen at Westfield Chermside. 23 cases are connected to the Portuguese family and Greek community centres.
This cluster of the Alpha variant is all coming together and we're finding out where all the issues are. And I expect we'll see a few more still come through.
An elderly man connected to the Portuguese restaurant, though, is now on a ventilator. Queensland and Canberra are a step closer to a federally funded, state-run quarantine camp to take the burden off the hotels. Canberra's proposed Pinkenba military base would have 1,000 beds for 1,450 guests, able to take 800 a fortnight at first, equal to two repatriation flights. Though the Premier is still pushing the Wellcamp Airport site near Toowoomba as well.
It has distinct advantages, not the least of which the planning is already done and ready to go.
Trouble is they're beating their heads against a brick wall. The Prime Minister's always said no and doesn't look like budging.
If we had both quarantine facilities, we would not need to use the hotels.
Lane Kelcutt, Nine News.
Straight to Alex Heinke at Westfield Garden City. Alex, there's an urgent warning tonight for Queenslanders who visited that Southside shopping centre.
Yeah, very urgent, Andrew. That is because a brand new list of exposure sites has just been released from Queensland Health. It means a person with COVID-19 has visited these locations, and we're going to bring these up on the screen for you right now. There's a lot of information to get through here, but we will work through it. So let's start with the Westfield Garden City Centre. If you visited this location between 1 and 4 o'clock on Monday the 28th of June, that's Wallace Bishop, the Optus store or the Sushi Hub, and then on Tuesday the 29th, any of these stores, Wallace Bishop, Woolworths and Cinnabon, you are now considered a close contact. Our other locations that have been visited, the Woolworths at Forest Lake, the IGA New Farm, the Night Owl at Kangaroo Point, and then again on the Wednesday, the 30th of June, the Target at Baranda and the Night Owl at Kangaroo Point. Finally, the Indooroopilly Shopping Centre was visited on the 2nd of July between the hours of 2:30 and 3:30. That's the Kmart, the JB Hi-Fi and the Woolworths at the Indooroopilly Shopping Centre as well. Now, if you have been to any of these locations at the times that you just saw on your screen, you are now going into home quarantine. The only reason that you can leave your home is to go and get a COVID test. You need to get one of those as soon as possible. And even if you get a negative result, you are still required to stay in home quarantine. And official from Queensland Health will be in contact with you to tell you what your next movements are. So, Melissa, if you have you thought you have visited any of those closed locations and you missed them, well, the full list is up on the Queensland Health website.
All right, Alex, thank you for that. Well, let's bring in crime reporter Sophie Upcroft now. Sophie, there is some confusion tonight over masks, when and where people in the southeast exactly need to be wearing them.
That's right, Melissa. With lockdown lifted and the mask mandate still in place, there is a lot of confusion and some panic about exactly when and where we need to wear a mask, with some people inadvertently breaking the rules and others dobbing people in who aren't actually breaking them. So we've clarified with Queensland Health exactly when you need to wear a mask while you're outside. So you actually can be in a group as long as those people are from your household or family and you are out in the open. But if you join up with another group, household or family, and you are mingling, then you need to put one on. However, if you are able to remain in two separate groups and socially distance, remaining 1.5 metres away at all times, then you don't have to wear one. If you are alone and you are exercising, eating or drinking or working, and you are able to socially distance, like I am right now, then you can go barefaced. But it is essential that you carry a mask with you at all times, just in case it becomes crowded and you need to put one on. Police are patrolling, and if they do find you not wearing a mask when you should be, they will hand you one and ask you to put it on. But if you do refuse, then they can fine you over $1,300 for breaching a direction of the Chief Health Officer. Andrew, we need to abide by these rules for at least the next 11 days.
And we need that on the fridge too, I think, Sophie. There's a lot to take in. Thanks. That is much clearer, though. Let's go to Natasha Kramer with new details on our struggling hotel quarantine network. Nat, hotels are full. The government wants to scrap the system, and families you're speaking with couldn't agree more.
Yes, Andrew, right now our hotel quarantine system is at capacity, and we've got around 3,000 people that are currently quarantining in 15 hotels, including the Ridges here behind me at Southbank. Negotiations are underway for those regional hubs, and the Premier today again highlighted that move is vital. Return travellers agreeing. They say our struggling system is having a huge effect on them. They too are at breaking point. A single room for a family of four. No kitchen, no space, and no fresh air.
It's incredibly frustrating.
With 1 and 4 year olds and their whole life packed into suitcases, the Wilson family hides behind furniture to get the youngest to sleep.
She's distressed by it. Our 4-year-old is distressed by it, and none of us are getting any sort of respite.
And they're paying $5,000 for the privilege, $2,000 more than an adult couple without kids would pay. But when they ask to be moved into a bigger room...
Our request has been denied. Our request for fresh air breaks have been denied.
Told switching rooms isn't possible because parts of the hotel are being used to house close contacts of recent COVID cases. The fully vaccinated couple questioning why home quarantine isn't yet possible.
The quarantine system should be utilising the fact that people are vaccinated to reduce this pinch on capacity.
You have to have mechanisms to ensure that people are staying at home, and don't forget, you can still have the virus and you can still transmit the virus.
Right across our system, facilities are being stretched. A pregnant mother who tested positive to COVID on day 6 in hotel quarantine, despite no symptoms, moved into this tiny hospital room to isolate with her little girl on Friday.
We can sleep together and we do activities.
Their belongings are yet to arrive.
No clean clothes, no toothbrushes, no body washes. There's not even a jug in this room to boil water.
Now the pair is facing 5 weeks in isolation. The kicker, they've been told 4-year-old Thea will need to restart quarantine from the end of her mum's 14 days, despite the pair sharing the same room the entire time.
They're calling a 4-year-old a close contact and deeming that she's such a high risk to the community, they must shove her in a hotel quarantine system again. It's cruel. It's cruel.
Queensland Health confirming the little girl will restart quarantine with her mum or a relative volunteering. Natasha Kramer, 9 News.